Hello friends, I hope you liked my last video, that is about operational qualification. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the performance qualification for computerized system. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please, if you like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. Now in this slide, we will discuss about the performance qualification for computerized system. So performance qualification assures that equipment or a system is capable of performing or controlling the activities of a process according to written and pre-approved specifications while operating in its specified operating environment. So as per the operating procedure of a particular equipment, system must perform the activity which shall be based on the product and process knowledge, right? So the main objective of the performance qualification is to verify and validate that software system performs as intended in the actual operating environment. So the system performance, as we discussed, based on the respective operating procedure. For example, if you are having a chromatographic system, then you require an instrument method, a processing method, and a sequence preparation, right? So in this, we can say that the system shall be performed based on the actual routine requirement. So in the performance qualification, we need to verify these things. Now next, we will discuss what is performance qualification protocol. So the performance qualification protocol is a collection of test cases used to verify the actual business processes. So here our actual business processes will be that how to create the instrument method, how to create the processing method, how to create a sequence in a chromatographic system, right? So as per the actual business processes, as per the routine requirement, right? So the performance qualification protocol should be approved before protocol execution. So performance qualification protocol should be approved by the quality, then only test can be performed. And also operational qualification must be executed and approved prior to start the performance qualification, right? So the executed protocol should be signed by the tester and reviewed by the system owner and approved by the quality. So now we will discuss what should cover in the performance qualification protocol. So as concerned with the respect to the performance qualification, so the performance qualifications should be considered to check the performance of the system with respect to the actual process, that is the process which are to be used for the routine activity, right? So following tests may be included but not limited to, that is verification of actual business processes. And as I explained, related to actual process for the routine activity. So now in this slide, we will discuss about the practical approach to write a performance qualification test script. So first is verification of method creation. So in this, we need to verify the system should allow to create the instrument method as per the respective product parameter requirements, right? For example, in case of chromatographic data system, we need to prepare the instrument method. For the creation of that instrument method, you require the wavelength parameter, column movement temperature parameter, and auto sampler temperature, flow rate of mobile phase, and other parameters based on the instrument method parameter which is mentioned in the respective product testing procedure. So such parameter we need to incorporate, and we can create the method. Next is verification of process run. That means you are now going to perform the test into that system. So after creation of instrument method, you need to create the sequence and processing method to execute the process of analysis, right? And after completion of run, you need to perform the some integration of chromatogram, and there will be a report template by which you can generate the required results. So next is verification of data and a report generation. So once you created the report, so here we need to verify that each requirements are printed on the report with respect to the product regulatory and data integrity related, right? So overall, in the performance qualification, we need to verify the actual process of the system, right? So friends, this is all about the performance qualification, and in the next video we will discuss about the validation summary report, that is called VSR. I hope this video will help to better understand what is performance qualification. Thank you.